In this video, I'm going to show you how to interpret the information found on your Meshtastic device. So first thing you will see when you start up your device, you'll see something on the left-hand side. This is also your LORA region. Now, how do you know which LORA region you fall under? Simply go to this URL, right? And when you load this page on a URL, you'll be able to check on the left-hand side the code and look for US. And then US means basically is the LORA frequency or the LORA region code for United States. Let me show you another example. Let's say if you see something else, you see SG_923. Same thing, go to the URL over here and look through the list. And you'll be able to find SG923 means is the LORA region code for Singapore 923 megahertz frequency. The next thing you're going to see on your device when you start up the screen is three numbers on the right-hand side. So as of April 2024, the latest firmware version is 2.3 point something. All right. So if you're not sure whether yours is the latest firmware basically means the software that's installed inside your device, you can go to this URL, flasher.meshtastic.org, choose the name of a device. I happen to have a Helltech V3. And click on the select firmware version. And when you click the drop down, they will show you two categories, stable version and alpha. Alpha is basically for people to test new features that are rolling up. And once the testing has been done and approved, then they will go into the stable version. So you usually want to look at the stable version first and then look for the latest one at the top and the first three numbers. So the first three numbers is basically 2.3.4. So if that matches your device firmware version, means you have the latest version. Now, if your number happened to be lower, for example, if your number on your device is 2.2.24 and the latest is 2.3.4 and you want to install the latest one, you can simply select it and click flash. But before that, connect your device to your computer using a serial cable. A node is basically a unit within the mesh network that can send, receive, and relay messages and information. To understand this better, I use an image from the Meshtastic.org website to explain a little bit more. So let's say this is your device and you're connected to your phone through Bluetooth so that you can type messages and send out using your device. Your device is considered one node. Other people are going to have their own device, again, connected through their own phone through Bluetooth. They are considered another node. So here you see one node, two node, three node, four node, five node, six node. All right. Some nodes are standalone. That means they don't require to connect to a phone to be able to send and receive because they have their own inbuilt keyboard. Okay. But most people will usually have devices that look similar to this. So let's say this represents your device. You're considered a node in a mesh network of many devices. So let's think about one scenario. The first scenario is that this is your device and you're at home connected to your phone through Bluetooth. And the name of the device, which later I'll teach you how to check, is called B100. So everybody have their own unique identifier name, right? So let's say your family member went up to the mountain to trek and he carried his own Meshtastic device and the name of his device is B500. So let's say he wants to update you that he's okay. So he sent a message down and he typed what's going on the mountain, all right, and how he's doing. So if you look at your device and read what's the message received, you're going to see something like this. So you may see, first of all, the sender of the message. So that's him, his B500. And when you look at the device, you will check the received time. So let's say the device received the message from him 20 seconds ago. And of course, the message itself. So he may say, weather at the mountain are clear and I'm safe. Okay? So let's say after you read this message and he wants to send a reply back to him. So again, you type on your phone and you send it up to him. And he's going to check his device and see what he can see. So he may see the sender of the message receives you, B100. And he got it 10 seconds ago. And he can see a message that you tell him Okay, see you later for dinner at home. So basically, the idea is your device, which is a node, will broadcast information to other nodes, even if you are not sending messages directly. They will basically broadcast telemetry information. So your screen, your node at the same time will receive information from other nodes, okay, because it's broadcast to you. So information could include name of the device, signal strength of the device, and the direction from your node. So, for example, this node, even though the person may not be typing messages to send to you, is still in the background sending basic information to the rest of the device, like telemetry information. Okay, so you'll be able to see the name of the node that transmits to you. All right, so in this case, it's B500. You'll be able to see how far the node is from you. Now, if you see question mark, means there's no GPS information on this device. Even if you have GPS, the software will not be able to calculate the distance apart. So if the person has GPS information and you have GPS information, the software will be able to calculate the distance between the two of you. And you'll be able to see the signal strength in percentage. The higher the percentage, the stronger the signal strength. If you find that the signal strength is getting low, but you want to be able to get consistent information or connection with this person, then you should try to move closer to the person, okay? So I'll talk more about this in a while's time. So be able to see also how long ago this telemetry information was transmitted to your device, was 1 minute ago, okay? So let's talk a little bit more about this person, this user. He's 10 kilometers away and he's to your east. So this is, let's say, the representation of the north and he's to your east. Now we're having good signal strength, so you don't really have to do anything. But let's say if this person is important to you, you want to continue to get good signal strength, you should either get the person to move closer to you or you move closer to him. So to move closer to him, you have to go towards your east a bit more. All right, the nearer you go, the signal strength should improve, including assuming all other things remain constant. If this person has no GPS, you will not see the end, but you'll see a huge question mark inside. So you do not know where the person is, and you will not see as well the kilometers. The kilometers will not be shown. Let's go to the next thing, okay? The next screen you will see is, of course, the battery percentage. Now, this is in 25% interval. So one bar represents approximately 25%. So if you're getting full 4 bars, means your battery is going to last quite a while depending on the size of your battery or the capacity of a battery. If you find that it drops 2 bar and below, it's time to get near to a battery charging source or connect to a power bank. So it's quite straightforward. Now, the next thing you'll be able to see is the word I bracket and device name. This is your device name. This is very helpful, especially if you have many devices at home, you get confused who is who, then this is actually the name of your device, okay? The next thing you'll be able to see is this number/number, okay? This basically means the number of connected nodes, okay? So the number 9 is basically all the previous nodes that were connected to you, they are logged in. And the first number here is the current now, how many nodes are connected to you. So here you don't see like 9 upon 9, you see only 6 upon 9. That means probably 3 of them have either went out of range or they've turned off the device and then that's why they're not connected to you. Okay. So the next thing you'll be able to see is your channel name and the list of the most recent nodes that joined this channel, okay? So let's say now you only see 4, and then 1 minute later you see one more appearing, means this person just turned on the device or has come into range with your device and is able to connect and send some information to you. So the next thing you see is if you see no GPS, this means your device does not have hardware is able to connect to the global positioning system. So you have no GPS function. If you want, you can learn how to add on by doing some soldering work or buying some module. But this means you have no GPS. Even if you try to turn it on, nothing will work. If you see instead, GPS is off. This means your hardware, your device has GPS feature, but you have turned it off either using the user button or you have turned it off at the Meshtastic, using the Meshtastic app itself on your smartphone. Okay? So this is usually you can choose to do that, for example, if you still want to send messages out, but you do not want the person to know your position due to privacy reason, so you can choose to turn it off. Okay? Now, if you choose to turn on your GPS and it gets a connection, you will be able to see this symbol. So this basically means location. Your location is logged with the GPS satellite. You'll be able to see the satellite strength. The higher the bar, the stronger the signal. And then the satellite signal, and then you see a number here. The number means the number of GPS satellites that are connected to you, because there are multiple GPS satellites up in space, right? So you may be connected to more than one at the same time. So be able to see the number. It may not be 5, it may be 3, it may be 6, it may be 2, it may be 1. Doesn't matter, all right? As long as you manage to lock with at least one, you'll be able to see more GPS information at the next screen. So the next screen you'll be able to see is your battery voltage. So B for battery, and this is the voltage. Meshtastic devices are basically 5 volt devices. However, most of the time, this may not be very much meaningful to a layman, but very meaningful to a technical person. So usually you also look at the battery percentage as an indicator. So the battery charge percentage, depending on hardware, because different Meshtastic device may have different power management. So not everybody may see a 100% when your battery is fully charged. That doesn't matter so much, I think, from my layperson perspective. You just want to make sure the percentage on the higher side. Again, more than 50% means you still have some battery life left. It's too low. Go near to a battery charging station using a USB cable or plug in a power bank. So this is just a relative representation to you on how much battery life you have left. And the next thing you'll be able to see is how long ago since your battery starts charging. So let's say you already plug your device to a power bank or to a USB port. You'll be able to see how long ago you started charging your battery. Okay? So the next thing you'll be able to see is the name of the channel. Long F means long fast. This is the most default channel that people will be on. So yeah, if you're on another channel, you may see something else, but most people are on long fast. And you'll see CHUTIL. This stands for channel utilization. And the number will range from 0% to 100%. Now, channel utilization refers to a measure of how busy or how active the network is. It helps us to understand, you know, the available bandwidth utilized by the device in the network. Okay, what does it really mean, the number? If this number is from 0 to 25%, generally very good. Most people that sends out message and receive packet means no issue, no loss of information. Now, if it's 25 to 50%, it's getting busier. The network's really getting busier, but still okay. Okay. Now, if it's more than 50%, means the network is quite down with traffic. The bandwidth is a bit lesser, not so good. So if you're not urgent, maybe wait for a little while for the number to drop back to these two ranges before you start to send out the network. So not to... If anybody else is have an emergency case and they send out a message, you want that to get through. If yours is not so urgent, just wait for a while for the percentage to drop below 50 before you send out. The best is of course drop back to below 25%. So take note, I feel my personal thought about this is usually during an emergency, let's say the power grid is down or some things have happened, like a tornado is coming. So in some natural disaster, everybody might get on the network and start messaging, so it may go up. So just take note and be aware of this percentage. Okay? So wait till the number percentage drop below 50 before you start to send out in important information. So if you do not have GPS function and device, you're gonna see GPS not present. Let's go to the next screen. Now, if you see GPS not locked. This means you have a GPS feature in your hardware device, but you have, and you have choose to turn it on, but your device was not able to establish a connection with the GPS satellite. So what can you do? Now, if you do want to go ahead and get a GPS lock on your location and send it out to the other people, other nodes, then you must move outdoor to preferably an unblocked place, like not blocked by structures, to try to get a good connection. And once you lock in, you should be able to see your GPS information, and that will be sent out by the node to the rest on the network. Okay? If you manage to get a GPS lock, you'll be able to see this screen. So for those of you who have no GPS function at all, you will never see this screen. Okay? So if you see this screen, means your GPS function, it was locked with the satellite. So you include the positional time span from the GPS satellite, as well as your altitude. Altitude means how high you are above sea level. So this information is useful for people, for example, if they want to track their loved ones, if they go high up in the mountain, tracking how high they went. Okay? So the lower you are to ground, the number of course meters will be lower. Okay? Same thing if you are on a building, but you're outdoor on the balcony. If you are able to get a GPS lock on the position, you'll be able to see the altitude as well. Okay? The next two sets of number you see, so are the latitude and the longitude. Latitude is here, longitude is here. You may see a positive number or a negative number. Now, how do you interpret this information? So this is just to give you some example on the idea of positive and negative number. But if you want, you can go to Google Map and pin these numbers and see the exact location of the person. For latitude, which is the first number, in this case is positive 36. So this means positive means the person is up on the north, negative means the person is down south, and zero means the person is on the equator. So since it's a positive 30, so you'll be around this region, okay? North. Now, if the longitude, if you see here, longitude is minus 118, means the person is more on the west side, negative minus 115, somewhere here. If it's positive number, you'd be more on the east. So the person now is on the here, but on here, all right? So this is a summary of what you'll be able to see on the information on my Meshtastic device. There are actually more information, but for most users, this is adequate for your day-to-day use.